chores? Obviously not. Locked.
Break from it all.
To make sure I don't. Yes, yes, please. Yes, I did it.
I'm counting to three. One, two, two and a half. Here I come! Generation. I told Ashman that we didn't need desperate children.
I have to stay calm. Coming.
Tired of all this. I just want a break from it all.
Oh no, what could the code be? Yes, yes, yes! The French window. Oh God, I'm freezing!
While they're wandering around the house, I am here, working my ass off. I told Ashman that we didn't need desperate children. supposed to be a hotel, but it feels more like an orphanage.
I must find a way to reach it. I made it. I can do it. I can do it. What are all these cages doing here? Felton?
What's going on, kids? Mommy is coming.
Andrea, I have to hide.
Shh, calm down, calm down. Everything is fine. Mommy is here. Mommy is exhausted. One of these days, you're all going to make me crazy.
Oh my God, I have to leave this place at once.
Have they completed their chores? Obviously not. I told Ashman that we didn't need desperate children.
Why me? Why? You can do it, Jen. You can do it!
I'm so tired of all this. I just want a break from it all.
This way!
It would be best if I just told him I don't work with crybabies.
I have to stay calm.
While they're wandering around the house, I am here, working my ass off. I'm so tired of all this. I just want a break from it all. While they're wandering around the house, I am here, working my ass off.
I don't want to die.
Have they completed
their
chores?
I don't want to die.
Obviously not. The only one who actually gets any work done around here is me. What's all that ruckus? It would be best if I just told him I don't work with crybabies.
Thank you.
no news regarding last night's massacre at the peaceful residence of Cerro Oscuro, where the body of Richard Felton, a well-known notary, was found burnt in his own home. The man who was legally registered as Jennifer Richard Dean Felton and was found completely drenched in kerosene. The body of 38-year-old Gloria Ashman was also found at the scene. She was his personal assistant and a former nun at the Cristo Morente convent. Her body was found mutilated after she was reported thrown out a courtyard-facing window, apparently following a heated argument. The neighbors claim to have spotted a distinctive woman lurking around the area, having parked a white van nearby.
Missing. February 8th, 1971. Celeste Felton, 13 years old. Beloved adopted daughter of Richard Felton and Ariana Gallo. You ran away from home, isn't that so? Why did you end up in this godforsaken place? Assigned by Flemington Institute to the Foster Home and Work Project at the Ashman Inn, 1973. Jennifer, just over 2 years older. Unknown parents. It's you, isn't it? Celeste Felton.
Miss?
Mr. Ashman is waiting for you. Did you say Reed? Are you a relative?
More like an old family friend.
Please come in, Miss Reed. Come in! Don't be afraid. I don't bite. What is Reed? A pun?
Good evening, Mr. Ashman.
You've certainly come a long way. You have gone from simple larceny and battery all the way to homicide and arson. Are you here to broaden your resume?
Do you remember me?
I'll never forget a face. Maybe because I don't have one anymore. I know exactly why you're here. The same exact reason why that son of a bitch Felton ended up like cooked meat. Whatever happened to Celeste Felton?
I have here a dossier from the Flemington Girls Institute granting custody of 15-year-old girl Jennifer and certifying that she is to be a housekeeper at this hotel. Celeste Felton and the girl in the photo are the same person, aren't they?
That girl was simply an orphan, a homeless nobody, and so I decided to take custody of her.
And she just so happened to be the adoptive daughter of your former hated business partner Felton by pure coincidence? I don't buy it. So, you're saying that besides synthesizing pharmaceutical drugs and spreading diseases, Mr. Felton and yourself were all dedicated to helping homeless minors?
It was never about synthesizing a disease, because the disease never existed.
And the moths?
Woken up at last.
Hey, calm down.
I barely touched her.
No, it wasn't a dream.
I found you at the bottom of the stairs. You hit your head and lost a lot of blood.
It was as if you were dead, Jim.
Andrea went crazy.
You must eat or drink something, young lady.
She wanted to kill me.
That's not possible, Jennifer. Andrea was with me.
Here you go. Drink up.
I am sure of what I saw.
Everything is all right now. Calm down.
There was also a large man. He had a strange wooden stick shaped like a spine.
Porcelain.
That man is dead, young lady.
No, I saw him. He was the one who pushed me down the stairs. You called him Wyman!
That thing is no longer Professor Wyman.
Andrea! That man is dead, and has been for a long time. He hung himself. You see, you were just dreaming.
I don't understand.
Jen, you have to calm down now.
You believe me, Lynn, don't you? You believe me, right?
She should get some rest now.
Jen, if you need anything...
I'm here for you.
Say goodbye. Party first from my eyes. If you leave me, are you sure you miss me? If you fly, you lose something in the sky. Listen to me.
Excuse me? Are you new?
I suppose so.
I love that song. Where are you from?
Flemington Girls Institute.
What did you do?
What do you mean?
If you get transferred here, it means you are a real problem.
Listen, I'm not up to making conversation.
Oh, well, I'm sorry, I guess. I was hoping we would get to know each other better. That's all.
I'm into illegal organ and drug trafficking. In my spare time, I exchange sex for cigarettes.
Nice. I was expecting more like controversial political activist, promoter of black slavery and preservation of the Aryan race.
Only in my spare time. Very well, you're right. I'm a real handful. Now, if you will excuse me.
The pleasure was all mine.
Is there something in the sky?
You have to wake up. I beg you, wake up.
Shit, they drugged you. Listen, you have to leave. You have to get away from this place.
This story again?
Everything you said before, I believe you. Porcelain and everything else you saw.
You heard Andrea. He hung himself years ago.
It's him, isn't it? Professor Albert Elias Wyman. The same walking stick you were talking about. See? It was all an act. There was no body. And if there had been, it wouldn't have been his.
I don't understand.
There's no time to explain. They know who you are. They know.
What are you talking about? Why didn't you ever say anything to me?
I tried to warn you. I tried to get you to leave. But you never understood, for fuck's sake!
Why? Who do they think I am?
Celeste Felton.
Me? No, I don't know. Oh God, Lynn, I can't remember!
They found you and they brought you here to use you. And now that they are sure of who they think you are, you have to run!
Fucking hell, Lynn, just tell me!
That drug... The disease!
And what does that have to do with me?
Your birth mother. She used loads of it. You got it from her. It's a part of you. Your organism hasn't shown any side effects. Your body lives in harmony with it. You can even control it. And they know it. Look me in the eyes, Jen. Look at me! You mustn't do anything or trust anyone.
Is this the reason why we met? Have you been pretending to be my friend this whole time?
No, Jen. It had nothing to do with this. I have always been honest with you.
Lynn! Lynn! Oh, dear God, no. Not again. Ah, my head.
Receives the presence of a possible threat to her throne, she does everything that she is capable of to maintain control over the others. Therefore, eliminating the threat.
Telephone. It's coming from Ashman's office.
Never lie.